Hello, Leo, and welcome to your mid-month reading. We are going to talk about money, career, and love. I'm going to separate the video for some people who just want to know about money and career and some people who just want to know about love. If you want to know how I do readings, like how I look into your energy and what the sun, moon, and rising signs are and how these energies can be reversed, and if it doesn't resonate you, what does that resonate with you? What does that mean? You can look in the description box down below for the July reading. That will explain all of that. It'll also give you essential oils and crystals. And then there's a releasing of trapped emotions meditation at the end, which will help you release some trapped emotions for July for those new people who have never been to my channel. We are going to first look at money and career. Let me go ahead and start getting the cards ready. I'm only accepting the highest and best truth for the Leo Collective's highest and best good, bringing forth the most accurate answers. Now, what I wanted to say about, like, the readers that are on YouTube right now, you're seeing that a lot of them are doing love. So those people who are really interested in just money and career, let me explain really quickly. There's a huge soulmate cycle that's happening right now with millions of people. The universe is trying to resolve some conflicts and resolve some soulmate relationships, a lot of them, to balance out the entire world. The whole world revolves around love. And these relationships, whether they are love relations, like actual like romantic relationships, or just maybe mother-daughter, father-son, just any kind of relationship. It could be friends. But whatever the soulmate cycle is trying to balance out, that is what is going on right now. So a lot of readers, it's not that we want to just read about love. We have to be specific if we're going to talk about career and money. But all the energy is the same. You'll kind of see how they look the same, right? But so a lot of the readings just come out as love because of that, because there's a lot of balancing of the soulmate cycle that's happening right now. It's huge. So if you're already in love and you're like, well, I'm already in love, I don't need to know. I get that. I understand that. And there's a lot of people who are suffering right now trying to get these love relationships balanced, okay? That's why you keep hearing about that. But what we're going to do is love and money. And let's see. We're going to do you now, your next step, what's in your way, what strength do you have, and your new focus or your outcome. Ooh, look at that. Leo, you are in the energy of manifestation, and also it has to do with career and enterprise, travel, work issues, all right? And then, like, you're going to feel very much like expressing yourself through your work endeavors, your money endeavors. And it's all through this cyclical way of manifestation. So this is something that you have a lot of experience with because you've done it in multiple past lives and you wanted to do it in this life as well. So you have like, you have a lot of hands-on experience with whatever it is that you're doing. You don't even know where the intuition comes from. You don't even know, like, why are you so good at this? But you are. You're really good at it because you've done it a lot of times. And this is you bringing in this innovation into your career and your money, okay? And this is you, we could say, the having all the tools that you need. Sometimes people say that with this card, like, oh, you have all the tools that you need, which is true because he's got cool tools on the table. But I think the most important thing about this card is that he's has his hand up to God, and he's like this. Like this, so that's very intuitive, and manifesting through intuition, and so, like, here's the thing. Like, I'd rather. Okay, it's good to have someone who's book smart and they kind of know the books and stuff, but it's even better to have someone who's book smart and super intuitive, right? Like, I used to say, I don't want anybody doing surgery on me unless I know that they believe in God. And the reason why is because I feel like if they don't have some sort of belief in something bigger than themselves, then they're missing a big part of that. If they're just so focused in on science and logic and they can't see that God is actually helping them through doing surgery on my body, you know, that I want them to have that intuition. I want them to go, you know what, the book says this, but I'm going to do it this way. Because I feel it. I know it. I'm getting this, like, thing. I know it. And then, because maybe if they did the book way, maybe I would die on the table. But if they did it this other way because they were listening to something bigger than themselves, and they were like, you know, I know what the book says, but yeah, I'm just not feeling it. I'm going to go in a different direction. And I kind of feel like you're doing the same thing. Like, maybe they would save my life because they listened to the angels and guides, or whoever, you know, their masters, whatever, you know, their master surgeon inside their heart and head, whatever. But maybe I live because of that. And the same type of thing here. It's like, you might look at it and go, you know what? I see that the book does it this way. I see everybody does it this way, but I'm just not going to do it that way. I'm going to do it this other way. And that right there is going to make you really successful. It's going to make you alive in what you're doing. You're going to feel really good. Okay. So how are you feeling when it comes to money and career? Dang, you're feeling really awesome. You're feeling like the King of Swords, so you're feeling very ambitious. You feel very intellectual about what you're doing, very logical. You're making really good judgments. You're being very methodical about what you're doing. And those of you who are in a career, you look really professional right now. People are like, oh, yeah. They're like, Leo takes charge. Leo looks pretty awesome. So that's good for those of you who are looking for a job because your energy looks really good. On the outside, you look like a king, whether you're a male or a female. You look like a king. They're like, yeah, let's get that king in our business, or let's hire that king, or that king's got it going on, right? So whatever you're doing, you're looking like a king. You're looking like a master. You're looking like someone who really knows what's up. Someone who takes charge and they get it done. And I think, Leo, that you like that because you're really fiery energy. Although this is more of an air sign energy, you still like that taking charge type of thing. Like, I am the king. Okay, that's awesome. The next step. All right, the next step is we're going to be more like the Emperor, creating stability, having a little bit more fire under our butts to get things done, right? The Emperor, if you want anybody to get anything done in the world, in your career and money, you want the Emperor to do that, okay? This is your next step. This is where you're going. You're going from a king turning into an emperor. It's like the Emperor is someone who, this is an advancement. I don't know if you can see that, but there's definitely an advancement of some sort, right? So you are already awesome, but you're going to become even more awesome. And then you have this staff right here, this pillar, this thing that you're like relying on. And the Emperor has everything that he needs. He has the money. He has a social status. He has the skill. He's an older man, so he has wisdom, right? He's been there, done that. He's lived it. Like, if you were younger and trying to do what you're doing, you may have done it in a misstep kind of way. But this person's not missing any steps. This person knows exactly what they're doing. They're going to take their time with it, and they're going to do it, okay? Very good. All right, so the next thing in your money and career, what is happening? What is the obstacle in your way? Ooh, feeling a little bit defensive. Something's making you feel defensive. So you've got all your ducks in a row and everything is where it needs to be, but something is standing in your way and making you feel like, man, if that thing was just gone, I'd be able to move even quicker and fuller. I'm gonna get into this a little bit more. Let's actually dive into that right now. Leo, let's find out what's in your way, what's the obstacle, what's holding you back? Something is making you feel very defensive, making you feel like you have to build a wall around yourself, like you can't do the things that you want to do because this thing is in the way. This thing is there, like won't leave, always around. You don't know how to tell them to go away, or you don't know how to get it out of your life, right? It's like kind of confusing. What do you do? I don't know. Let's find out a little bit more. I get it. Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, here you go. All right. It's like on this one side of you, you have everything going right. Everything's going so well. That's from Moulin Rouge. That's right. And the big guy's coming out. He's like, everything's going so well. It's like you feel that. You feel so good. Like everything's moving in the right direction. You have everything the way that you want it. And then there's this thing that keeps showing up. And it's moving really, really slowly. It won't just get out of the way, right? It's like it just keeps being there. All you want to do is have it move forward. Just move on down the road. Move on down the road, right? It's like that. It's like, just go, please, is the energy that you're getting off of that. But here's the thing. This is really important. Is that thing or whatever it is that is blocking you, okay, I heard something really funny in my head, but I don't know if I could say it on YouTube, and I don't want to get dinged, so, but anyway, that thing that is, okay, so it starts with a C and ends with awk, that thing that is C and then awk, blocking you. It's because you're supposed to be going through a tower moment because of it. So it's going to trigger you to go through a tower moment, which is really interesting because Libra just got this, that somebody is going to be going through a tower moment and transforming. So maybe it's you. Anyway, this thing or this person or whatever it is that keeps coming up for you is going to trigger you so that you can look at it and get rid of the energy. So don't get attached to whatever is happening. Your job is just to move through the emotion and move through whatever's bringing up for you. A lot of writing and a lot of burning of things, burning of your writings would be good because we have to write it to get it out into the 3D dimensional reality. We can't keep it inside of our heads. We can't keep it inside of our bodies. It's just circling around and just making a mess. So this person or thing is going to trigger you. You need to write it out and burn it and start to become rid of the energy because, so I was told that when you karmically release the things in your body that no longer serve you, then those triggers cannot come up for you anymore, but you have to do the work. So let's say, for instance, this is a narcissistic person. Okay, let's say that this is a person that you've been trying to get rid of, but they just keep coming back and keep coming back and keep coming back. Okay, so what I would do, and I did the same type of work, I did it with my mother. What I would do is like, if you have a conversation or that person's around and they trigger you and you want to yell and you want to get angry and you want to tell them off or whatever, don't, because it's wasted energy on a narcissist, so don't. But what you want to do is take that energy and take it to a pen and paper and write it down. Write an apology to yourself. Write an apology to them. I apologize to my mom energetically. I didn't do it to her face because why? Okay. So because that's a narcissist and then they just take that power and run with it. They want you to be apologetic, but you're not apologizing for them. You're apologizing for you. So what do you need to give it to them for to give them more power? So apologize to them, then write a letter from them to you about what, all the things they did to you, apologizing to you. You need to get rid of all of that energy. Maybe you go see a shaman and get them to pull out some of that negative energy. Maybe you get, you know, maybe you go see people to help you with this. And because whatever you're going to need to do is every time you pull out energy that they're trying to connect you with, because you have connectors with your abusers. Every time you cut a cord of energy and you heal that sector of yourself, then what you're doing is when they try to trigger you, they can't affect you anymore. Then the devil energy will come towards you and you'll be like, I don't even recognize that devil energy. I don't feel that devil energy anymore. And you won't attract that type of devil energy anymore. But you have some work to do because you have this tower moment. Don't be afraid of tower moments. They're actually my favorite moments. I mean, I don't enjoy going through them, but what happens on the other side of them, I really do enjoy that. Like, I enjoy the happiness that it brings. I enjoy cutting those cords, cutting the connectors that I have to my abusers. So they don't have control over you anymore. All right. So that's kind of what I feel like is happening. That's crazy. And what it's going to do though, is bring you happiness. It's going to make you feel like your old self again. You're going to feel like like you were when you were younger and the world was yours, you know, and you're like, I'm going to go conquer the world. I don't care what's going on in my life. I don't care that, you know, my parents are being ugly and I don't care that, you know, I don't have the things that I want because, you know, you're only like 15, 16, 17, 18 years old, you have the whole world in front of you. You're like, I don't care what happened to me until I was 18. I'm out of here. Peace. I'm going to go make my world my world. And that's kind of what you told yourself. But then you got hooked up with this devil energy and you got hooked up with whatever was happening here. And this person was holding you back. But it is a blessing in disguise because this will help you release this, which is probably childhood trauma, right? The reason why you attracted this person anyway. Okay, cool. Great. Do your relationship healing with this person. All right. I know you're probably like, I'd rather heal with another person. This person is not fun to heal with. Okay, great. But they're still giving you a lot to heal from. So be happy and grateful for that. Okay, great. What are you going to bring up for me today? You know what I mean? And don't just go out there and I see like someone chopping wood because they're pissed. You know what I mean? Don't just go out there and just start chopping wood. You know what I mean? Like, oh, I hate you. Chop more wood. Oh, I hate you. Okay, that's good and all. But you got to actually say, what do you hate? You hate the way they treat you. You hate the way they make you feel so low. You hate the way they take away your identity. You hate the way that they don't make you feel like the King of Swords. when they're not around, you feel like the King of Swords. I'm amazing. I'm amazing. Whether you're male or female, it doesn't matter. I'm the King of Swords, right? And then they come around and then they make you feel like you're not. They make you feel like upside down. That's why you want them to go. That's why you want them to leave. But whether they leave or not, here's the thing. The energy is still there. You could be, I moved states away from my mother and she still controlled me. I moved states. I moved to a different country for 4 years and she still controlled me. And I didn't even talk to her on the phone for 4 years. So I get it. But here's the thing. She still controlled me emotionally in my marriage. Things happened in my marriage and it triggered my childhood. And then next thing you know, my mother's controlling me in my marriage. So this person, doesn't matter if they were to physically leave. I know you want them to because you just want to be by yourself. I get it. And it doesn't matter because if they leave, they're still controlling you emotionally. They still have the cord connections. The cord connections are there. You have to break the cords. You have to cut the cords. And I physically went to a shaman to cut some of those cords. Like I've been to three, you know, and it's like every single shaman and medium I went to was like, you have to cut your mother out. I was like, wow, it took me a good 4 years, but I finally did it. So because it was just unhealthy. So anyway, I get it. I understand it. Just use it to your advantage. Go through the tower moment. Hip, hip, hooray. We're done with the tower moment. And now we have our happiness. Oh, here it comes again. Tower moment. Person steps back into your life. Tower moment. Good. I release what I need to by writing it out, burning it. You don't have no more control over me. Now I feel like a child again. Yay. And then again, and again, and again, and again. It just happens. Okay. Until finally this person comes around and tries to trigger you and they can't anymore. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Because what happened was, it's the last straw. My mom wrote me a horrible letter. It was like 3 pages long. She gave me an email. And it triggered me into a tower moment, but it didn't trigger me into feeling this way, like it always had. Didn't trigger me to be upside down for who I really was. It triggered me to say, I like this feeling better than you, so I think it's time for you to go. Okay? Well, that was interesting. That was really long. Okay, it's okay. I don't know how long this video is going to be. All right, the thing that's helping you is that the blocks are being lifted and the events are speeding up. So the universe is on your side with this one. So this is really important for you because I know sometimes you felt like in the past that God, where was God? Where was God when I needed him? Well, God has his hand in this one. The universe is helping you with this one. It's time for you to take action. We talked about it already. The thing that you need is, the thing that's your strength is that you're a good writer. So you can write these things out. I did have someone who said that every time I try to write, I feel like I can't because that person's mom used to read her journal. That happened to me too. So I was like, oh gosh, me too. So I get that. What you have to do is you have to sit with yourself daily with a pen and paper and just show yourself that you're going to be there. And you just got to do it daily, every day. Every day you say, you know what, every day I'm just going to keep trying. I'm just going to keep trying. I'm just going to keep trying until you do it. You look at pictures of yourself when you were really young and you talk to yourself and say, I'm here for you. Nobody's going to read your stuff. We could put it in a private box, a locked box or something and burn it all when we're done so nobody ever gets to see it, just me and you, that type of stuff and that type of work so that you can start writing again. But I really feel like you're going to be able to write. So that's good. The other thing is you're going to feel like wanting to travel. You're going to feel very fired up. And are we still in, we're still in money and career? How did this turn into like a soulmate energy almost? I tell you, dude, it's like I cannot get away from it. But anyway, we'll still try. So anyway, you're going to feel like traveling maybe to career and money and all of those things. And then you're definitely going to feel very ambitious and fired up and wanting to take action through all of this. And that is your strength. Okay. Wow. That was really interesting. So let me go back to this because what I heard was more of a relationship issue. So let me just go back and clear this up too, because I got to really focus in on career if I'm going to read it that way. This right here could be a boss that treated you so badly. You have to do the energetic work. But the boss that keeps coming into your life would be triggered from maybe some things that happened in your childhood. That's why it's important for you to do this type of work. A lot of you guys, this is going to be maybe a love relationship that's causing this problem, holding you back in your career, holding you back in this ambitious way. Oh my gosh, that was crazy. It took me on a different adventure for a second. All right, so what is the outcome? Is that you're going to see the illusions in the career, illusions that have been happening in your money. This could be that this person was a gambler. This person was doing things with money, hiding money that you didn't see. So be aware of that. When we get this card and it has to do with money as the outcome or career, it means that you were illusioned in some way. It means that somebody, and I have a feeling it's this person who you just want to let go, whether it's your boss or whether it's your person in your life that is your relationship partner, or just somebody you work with, like a coworker, somebody provided an illusion in your career and in your money and really caused, I gotta see this. I don't know, I might need to separate this into two videos because this one's super long. We went into career and it got a little nutty. All right, let's see. I gotta see what's going on with this illusion though. Like, what was Leo illusioned by in their career and money? I might have to do part two, or this video is going to be like an hour long. I'll separate it into money, and you guys can come back many times if you don't have time to watch this. Okay, it's truth. I mean, it is what it is. This is what I'm saying. It's the sword of truth. So you definitely, there has been some deceiving energy somewhere, something in the career and money. And although we have this amazing stuff right here, there is something holding you back, making you be defensive. You're in great energy, but something is not, it's not good. And this is, when it's upright this way, it's the opposite of the devil. But whatever it is not in your highest good. This sword of truth that was the illusion, it's not good. It's not good. There's something that is holding you back from your happiness. This person wasn't helping you with your work, with your job, your career. They were holding you back. Oh my gosh. Yeah, so that's not pretty. Let's see what your advice is. I got to get some advice cards. Somebody was being very deceitful when it comes to money and career. Well, I'm sorry, Leo. That's not cool. But luckily, you know, and so you can go take a look at it. And I hope this isn't like a whole bunch of Leos. I'll feel bad for the entire collective that somebody was being so deceitful with money in your career. When you have such great manifestation going on, you have such great energy through the entire thing. Maybe the manifestation is so that you can see all this crap. What is the advice? All right, this is, yeah, okay, I hear it. Here we go. It's time to take action on this illusion, this person, this devil energy. I don't have the devil, but it really feels like it. Whatever's making you feel defensive and holding you back from your happiness. Remember that nothing is set in stone, meaning this person cannot have this hold over you. So no matter whatever you find out, remember that God has his hand in this one, this manifestation. This is God stepping in and saying, you have to see this so you can move forward in your money and your career. Okay. Nothing is set in stone means that no matter what you find out and no matter how bad it is, you're going to be able to move through it. Okay. It's going to make you step out of your comfort zone and be you and solely rely on you, because this person has brought in such negative energy and such an experience for you, okay? And here's the crazy thing, is when this card is upside down, its luck is on your side, which means doors will be opening for you. What they're showing me though, is this person is trying to close the doors. This person is trying to not help, is not allowing you to move forward. They want to keep you down. They don't want you to be as amazing as you are. You're only allowed to be so amazing. You're only allowed to be this much. So there is something that you definitely need to move through, to be aware of, to look at, stop being in this illusion about, so that you can move forward and move through that energy. Wow, Leo, that was crazy. Where are we at? 25 minutes. I think I'm going to do a part one and a part two. So we'll just do career and then we'll turn around and do love and money next, because this was insane. All right. If you like this video or entertained in some way, don't forget to like and subscribe and look for part two. It's going to be right next to this one because I'm going to do it right now. I just don't want you to have to watch an hour long video. That's just crazy. All right, you guys. And for me to process that takes a long time too. All right. Bye. I'll see you later. Bye.